So in previous lectures, we have seen the programs how to toggle onboard LED and how to toggle LED which is externally interfaced with Arduino board. Now we will extend our discussion for a traffic light controller. Now in traffic light controller we have three LEDs, and these three LEDs they have one particular sequence for turn on and off, right? So basic concept will remain same. We have to interface the LEDs with the Arduino, and by now we already know how to interface the LEDs with Arduino. Now to toggle one LED, we have already written the program. Now only thing is we have to extend our this concept for three LEDs, because in traffic light control unit there are three LEDs which are toggling in a particular sequence. So now in this program, write a program and develop an interfacing circuit with Arduino Uno board for the implementation of traffic light logic. Okay, so this is our traffic light logic. In total there are four states, right? There are three LEDs. First we talk about state one. Red LED, orange LED and green LED. These are the three LEDs. Let us assume that in state 1 our red LED is on and orange, green, these two LEDs are off, and the system will remain in this state for 10 seconds. So this position of red on, orange off, green off, this position will remain as it is for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, our system will move to next state, and that is our state number 2. Now in state number 2, you just think how our traffic light signal works. So initially red is on, orange and green is off. Now what will happen in state 2? In state 2, red LED is on. Already it was on in state 1, but now orange LED will also on, right? And green will remain off, and this is my second state. So now in second state, two LEDs are on, red and orange, right? So here the orange LED is on just to give the indication to the traffic that very soon the state of red and green is going to change, right? Very soon the state of red and green is going to change, because you see in state 3 red is on and green is off. Now very soon red is going to off and green is going to on, right? So this is the indication given by orange. It will give an alert signal to the traffic. So now the system will remain in this state for 5 seconds, right? So by the end of this state 2, if you calculate red LED, it is on for how much duration? By the end of state 2, 5 seconds for state 2, red LED is on, and now in state 1, red LED is on for 10 seconds. So overall red LED is on for 15 seconds, right? And what about orange? What about orange LED? For how much duration it is on by the end of state 2? So in state 1 orange is off, now in state 2, sorry, in state 1 orange is off, now in state 2 orange is on, and it is for 5 seconds. This state is for 5 seconds. So orange is on for 5 seconds. And what about green? green, it is off in state 1 as well as in state 2. So this green is off, green is off for 15 seconds, right? These red and orange, so here I am writing for on time. Okay, so by the end of state 2, red LED is on for 15 seconds, orange is on for 5 seconds. Now after state 2, system will move to state 3, and state 3, what will happen? Red and green, they will change the states now. So red will become off and green will become on, and orange is also off in state 3, and system will remain in this state for 10 seconds, just similar to state 1. Now only difference between state 1 and state 3 is, in state 1, red LED is on and green is off, whereas in state 3, red is off and green is off. Regarding orange, both are off, means orange is off in both the states. Now after 10 seconds, system will move to state number 4. Now in state number 4, red and green, they will remain as it is, as they were in state 3, means red is off, green is on. The only change is this orange LED. Now this orange LED is on. So always remember, whenever orange LED is on, it gives the indication to the traffic that very soon the state of red and green LEDs are going to change, right? So now you can see, by the end of state 4, if you calculate state 3 and state 4 together, then by the end of state 4, red LED is off, right? For how much duration? 10 seconds in 3 state and 5 seconds in 4th state. So off for 15 seconds. Now what about green? Green LED. So green LED is on. So see, in state 3rd it is on for 10 seconds. In state 4 it is on for 5 seconds. So it is totally on for 15 seconds. Now what about orange? Now orange LED, by the end of state 4, it is on for only 5 seconds, because in state 3 orange LED is off, and in state 4 it is on, but for 5 seconds only. So now after state 4, system will again go back to state number 1. So this is the total logic of traffic light controller. And now we have to develop the code for this traffic light controller, right? Arduino Uno code for this. So if you see the interfacing circuit, it looks like this. So here we have three LEDs. First one, this is green, this is green, then orange in the middle, then red LED. Okay, now this is the cathode terminal of green LED. This side, this is the cathode terminal of orange LED. This is the cathode terminal of red LED. Now this side, the anode terminal of green, anode terminal of orange, anode terminal of red. So these three anode terminals are connected to the pins of digital pins of this Arduino Uno board through resistors, right? So here we have taken here you can take 250 ohm, here I have taken 250 ohm resistor. So what is the purpose of this resistor? This resistor is used to bring down the current which is coming out from the pin of the Arduino to the safe label of the current, which can be allowed to pass through the LEDs, right, without its burning. So already in last lecture we have calculated how to calculate these, the values of the resistance, right? So now here you can see, so anode of green LED is connected to pin number 13, and anode of orange LED is connected to pin number 12, and for red LED anode is connected to pin number 11. So 11, 12, 13, all these are digital pins. So with these pins I have connected 3 LEDs, right? Now to turn on LED, we have to generate a plus 5 volt signal from these pins, pin number 13, 12 or 11. And to turn off the LED, we have to generate 0 volt. Because you can see here the cathode terminals of all the 3 LEDs, these are joined together, and from here I have connected this junction to this ground pin, right? So the cathode terminal of all these 3 LEDs are connected to ground. Now if the anode terminal receives plus 5 volt, LED will on. If the anode terminal will receive 0 volt, LED is off, right? So how to turn on and off the LED? Simply by generating the plus 5 volt or 0 volt through pin number 13, 12 and 11. And for how much duration these LEDs will be on? So this can be controlled by writing delay function in our program. If in our program we write delay, 10,000. So what is the meaning of this? So in delay function, whatever we write inside the bracket, that will be in millisecond. So 10,000 millisecond, and 10,000 millisecond in terms of seconds, it is equal to 10 seconds, right? So in this way we can generate the delay so that the LED is on for particular duration. Okay. So now we will see the program, traffic light logic program. So now in first three statements, I have declared pin number, declared the variables with the name of red, orange and green, and the pin numbers which are assigned to red is 11, to orange it is 12, to green it is 13, right? It is in the same way how we have connected our LEDs. Red LED is connected to pin number 11, orange to pin number 12, same way green to pin number 13, and in same way we have given the names to these pins. 11 is red, 12 is orange and 13 is green. Now in setup part we have written three statements, and these statements will declare the three pins, pin number 11, pin number 12 and pin number 13 as a output pin, right? Because we have connected the LEDs with these pins, and LED is a output device. So see this statement, pin mode. So this function already we discussed, this function is used to declare a pin as an input or output, right? So pin mode red output, pin mode orange output, pin mode green output. So in this way pin number 11, 12 and 13 are declared as output pin. Okay, so our initialization is completed. Now we will come to the loop part of our program. So in the loop part, first these three statements, 1, 2 and 3. So digital write, red is equal to high. So red means, I will write here, pin number 11, pin number pin number 13, right? So 11 is red, 12 is orange, and 13 is green. Okay, so this is statement 1, digital write red comma high. So what it will do, at pin number 11 it will generate high, means 5 volt. Then statement number 2, digital write orange comma low. So orange means pin number 12, so from pin number 12 low means 0 volt will be generated. Now third statement, digital write green comma low. So green means pin number 13, from pin number 13 0 volt will be generated, right? So now if this is the position, so with this 5 volt will on red LED, because due to this 5 volt this pin number 11 is connected to the anode. You can see here pin number 11, right? Pin number 11 is connected to the anode, right? So anode is having plus 5 volt, and here cathode, this is connected to ground, so our this LED is forward biased, and due to that this LED is on. So let red LED is on orange, so 0 volt at the anode and cathode is already at ground, so there is no potential difference, so LED will not be forward biased, so this will be in off position, this will be in off position. Same way pin number 13 will generate 0 volt, so with this green LED is connected, this will be also in off position. So red on, so now see the state 1, red on, orange off and green off. So this is the state 1. So state 1 should remain in this state for 10 seconds. That's why statement number 4 is used to generate the delay of 10 seconds, so delay 10,000. So with this our state 1 is completed. Now in state 2, what we have to do, we have to red on, orange on and green off. So see the statement number 5, red high, this means red is on. Statement number 6, digital write orange high, so with this orange LED is also on. And statement number 7, green low, so green is off, orange is on, red is on. So this is my state number 2, and it will remain the same position should remain as it is for 5 seconds. That's why my state number 8 is statement 8 is delay 5000. It will generate a delay of 5 seconds, right? So in this way we have written the programs. So these set of instructions are used for our state 1. These instructions are used for generation of state 2. Then these set of instructions are used to generate state 3, and these set of instructions are used to generate state 4. And after state 4, so this is the last instruction of the state 4. So after this last instruction, program will be executed from first instruction of the loop function. So in this way, continuously this program will run, and this logic, traffic light logic, you can observe, right? Okay. So in next lecture, I will demonstrate to you how exactly you have to do the interfacing with the real Arduino, and you can see how it is working. Okay, right.